thanks for returning. I hope this video finds you happy and doing well. As you know by the thumbnail, this video is going to be on some new products recently launched by Fashion Fair. So if you're interested, then just keep watching. So all of you ladies that are out there that are kinda in my age group, you all know about Fashion Fair. You gotta know about Fashion Fair. Well, they've just recently relaunched some makeup products and I decided to pick up two products. I have two to show you. I have the cream powder foundation, comes in a box like this, and I have the pressed powder and comes in a box like this. So, I think what I'm gonna do is, in order to kind of keep this video as brief as possible, is I'm going to, while I'm talking, I'm going to show you the demo and everything that I wanna show you all at once instead of talking and then showing you everything. So with that being said, let's just go ahead and get into it. So the first thing that I have to show you all is the cream to powder skin foundation. It retails for $37 and it looks like that they have 14 shades, although I don't know why. I was thinking that they had more than that. But anyway, it comes in a very pretty white packaging like this. I do have to say that even though it looks pretty, it doesn't really feel substantial. So I just thought I'd kind of give you a little bit of warning about that. It just kind of reminds you of this Milani Cream Compact, kind of like the same caliber. Although you do get a mirror in here, which is really nice, and you also get the little pad which you can put in the back right here. So the shade that I have is Topaz Trophy, and in the store it looked like that would be the close shade to closely match me. I applied it with a brush on one side, as you can see, and then on the other side I used the sponge. However, I just felt as though I really couldn't get a good application in with just the sponge. So after I applied the foundation with the sponge on the other side, I just decided to go back in all over with the brush. So this foundation is a cream formula, as you already know. It has a natural finish, it's fragrance free, medium coverage, it has vitamin C, and it's cruelty free, which is really nice. I do like the fact that it also has turmeric in it, and you all know that anytime I see a foundation that has some good ingredients in it, then I'm just gonna automatically gravitate to it. I can really appreciate the shades. You know, I feel like if you're a woman of color and you have problems, you know, with shade, you know, finding your shade and things like that, I think that you might want to check Fashion Fair out. Now, with that being said, I did also pick up the powder, and this is the Iconic Press Powder, and the shade that I picked it up in is Enchanting Amber. So this retails for $34 and it has a total of 12 shades. And this is another one where you get medium coverage. Again, it's cruelty free, vegan, fragrance free, and it has a matte finish. This one also has vitamin C in it. You get a Fashion Fair Blue Light Protection Complex and glycerin in it. So that sounds really good to me. It is recommended for all skin types. So I have it on now, and I'm gonna tell you the parts that I had that I struggled with is I have some deep smile lines right here. So what I did to kind of combat that is I used the Urban Decay All Nighter Ultra Glow Spray. I sprayed that And after I sprayed it, I put some more powder on top of it, and I feel like that made it a little bit less apparent. I did prep my skin with the Beauty Pie Super Drops Brightening Serum, and I elected to go with this because it is very thin and it provides some good hydration as well. And I just kind of wanted to see how it would play with, you know, just different skincare. A lot of times I'll talk about how some products don't play well with others, but I found that with the skincare it played really well, even with the concealer. And in this little clip you can see where I am applying the Kosas concealer to highlight under my eyes and, you know, to cover up my dark spots and things like that. Played very well with that. I also set the concealer with my Givenchy powder, and I think that it turned out really pretty. As far as the bronzing and things like that, even with the bronzer, I just elected to go with the Multi-Stick by Maybelline. And you all know you can either use that as a foundation or you can use it to bronze or contour or whatever, and I elected to do that. And I just blended it out, and everything blended well. There was no breaking up or separation or anything like that. So what I can say that I do love about this product is that it's got some good ingredients. I love the shades. You know, I found as though for me it was easy for me to pick a shade that I feel as though matches me very well. I'll just show you in some clips in natural lighting where I feel as though this is an excellent match for me. And another thing that I want to share with you all is that I wore it around my family and daughter. You know, I said, well, what do you think about my makeup? She said, I didn't even know you had on foundation. And that's a compliment when you have on makeup and someone tells you that they didn't know that you had on foundation. She said, yeah, mom, I can see that you have on lashes and lipstick and eyeliner and all that other stuff. She said, but I didn't know that you had on that. So you can get it's not giving heavy makeup type of vibes. It literally feels like you don't have anything on. And again, the only thing that I would have issue with is just kind of combating this right here, the smile lines, because, you know, the cream mixed with the powder, I don't know, I just found that right up in here is a problem area. And even once you apply the powder on top of the foundation, it doesn't feel matte. You know, some mattes, when you hear matte, you think of something very drying, something that's just gonna suck the life out of you and everybody else. I'm not getting that with this. I'm just not getting it at all. Now, mind you, I did set it with this, but that was after, you know, I saw that I was kind of having an issue with the smile line situation. Even before then, it just did not feel tight. It just feels really light. As far as the coverage, I think for me, I get better coverage with this. So I applied it, you know, with that, with my little sponge. And then after that, I took a dense brush and just kind of blended it out. And I feel as though you can layer it, but, you know, just like with any other foundation, the more you layer, the thicker it's going to appear and things like that. And, you know, the coverage, it's okay. I think it's medium coverage. I still see, you know, some of my problems area peeping through, which is fine. So just know that it's definitely not going to give you full coverage. Now, as far as what I would recommend, like if you could only just get two, I would say to get the powder. I really do like the powder. And another thing that I have to say about the powder is that it does have some kick up, and that could be because of my brush that I used. You know, maybe it's not the softest brush. I do honestly feel as though, you know, a lot of kick up that happens in the pan is contributed to, you know, the type of brush you have. So yeah, I really, really, really like the powder. I like both of them. But if you were just gonna ask me, well, Bridget, which one would you get? I would say get the powder, because yeah. But these two together, this combo from now on will be, I can just tell you, it's gonna be my go-to set. Only because, or mainly because, it is it's so easy to use. You know, to get on cream, you know, and then to just blend it in with this and go. You know, it's really easy. Plus, I like the shade. I think the shade looks really good. I think it complements me well, and I think that it looks really good in public, you know, in natural lighting. Because remember, ladies, you know, that, you know, when you're in my age group, that's the ultimate goal. You want to look as natural as possible when you go out, when you're, you know, you're seen and things like that. And I think that these two can help you get there. So yeah, that's it, short and sweet. You know, those are my thoughts on the new powder and cream foundation. What I am going to pick up during the Sephora sale, what I hope to get, is the lipsticks. But they're so pricey. They're like $26 a pop. I would love to have all of those. Fashion Fair, are you watching? I would love to have all of those. But anyway, those are gonna be on my list next to get, because I swatched them and the formula is so divine and the packaging is nice as well. So anyway, that concludes my review. Let me know down in the comments, do you plan on checking Fashion Fair out? If so, let me know. I'd love to hear about it. Thank you so much for tuning in, and until my next video, smooches.